Hi everyone, welcome to another LookdevX tutorial. This is the first one in a two-part series. Using this paper lamp as an example, I'll guide you through the procedural workflow from Bifrost USD to LookdevX. In this video, I'll briefly demonstrate how to procedurally create the USD stage for the lamp geometry in Bifrost, and then I'll show you how to create materials for it in LookdevX. In the next video, we'll create instances of the lamp and focus on how to create variations in the look of the lamps efficiently. If you're new to LookdevX, be sure to watch the intro to LookdevX tutorial that I made earlier. Without further ado, let's dive right in. Here I'm inside the Bifrost graph editor. This compound I created outputs both the lamp shade and the lamp stem. In the parameters panel, you can change it to an accordion shape by checking zigzag. And you can play with the parameters to change the radius, length, etc. This part is for the next video, no need to worry about it right now. All these are included in the scene file. You'll find the link to all the files for this tutorial in the description, including the scene, the texture images, and the USD files. If you're interested in learning more about Bifrost, there are also links to Bifrost tutorials down below. Now let's take a look at this diagram, which shows the workflow. For the geometry, we're going to use Bifrost USD to create a stage with one layer. It will contain an X-form prim with two child prims. One is the lamp shade, the other the lamp stem. Then we'll create another USD stage in Maya, load the geometry layer as a sublayer, and create another sublayer for the materials. And in LookdevX, we'll create the materials and assign them to the lamp shade and stem. First, I'll create a USD stage for the geometry. What I'll do is to convert the two Bifrost geometries, the lampshade and the lampstem, into USD prims. Since we don't need to output the Bifrost geometries, let's disconnect them from the output and delete the ports. To create a USD stage in Bifrost, we use the node create USD stage. In the parameters panel, we can choose the location where we want to save the USD file. Let's name it lampgeo.usd. To create the prims, first I'll get a define USD prim. Here the default prim type is X-form, which acts as a container, and is the type that we want. I'm going to rename the path to lamp. To add this prim to the stage, we use the node addToStage. Connect the stage and the prim to it, and the outstage to the output. In the outliner, we see that a new stage has been created. Go to the attribute editor, check shareable, and now in the USD layer editor, we see this lampgeo.usd layer that we just created. Now I'm going to create the children of the prim lamp. Hover your mouse over children, right-click, and select Define USD Mesh. I'm going to rename it to Lamp Shade. Copy and paste it, rename this one to Lamp Stem, and connect it to the port children. What I'm going to do next is to provide each of these two nodes with the corresponding Bifrost geometry, so that it knows which mesh geometry the USD prim should be based on. For the lampshade prim, we want it to be based on the lampshade geometry, so let's connect the lampshade to the port mesh of this node. Now we see the lampshade in the viewport, which means the USD prim lampshade has been successfully created. Similarly, let's connect the lamp stem to the mesh port here. And now we see the entire lamp in the viewport. In the outliner, we also see the prim lamp, which has two children, lampshade and lampstem. To save the USD stage, we can use the Save USD Stage node. Insert it between the addToStage and the output. Check Enable, and the file is saved to the location we specified earlier. That's how we prepare the USD geometry. Now let's move on to the materials. First, we're going to create a new stage for the paper lamp that will contain both the geometry and the material. Go to the USD layer editor, under Create, select Stage with New Layer. Right-click, select Save As. I'm going to name it lamp.usd, and save it in the same folder as the lamp.geo.usd file. This is our root layer for the paper lamp stage, under which we'll have two sublayers, one for the geometry and the other for the materials. For the geometry sublayer, I'm going to load the lampgeo.usd file that we just created. To do that, just right-click, select Load Sublayers, and select the file lampgeo.usd. For the material, I'm going to create a new sublayer by right-clicking and selecting Add Sublayer. Double-click and save it as lampmtl.usd. Be sure to target the material sublayer by clicking the circle here, because we want all the following procedures to be written on this layer. Now we're ready to create the materials. In the outliner, let's hide the previous stage we created using Bifrost USD, and rename the current stage Paper Lamp. Here we see the prims that we created and stored in the lampgeo.usd file. Let's hide the Bifrost graph as well. To assign material to a prim, select the prim, right-click, and go to Assign New Material. In the previous tutorial, I used MaterialX. This time, I'm going to demonstrate using Arnold. Select AI Standard Surface. This creates a material container that has an Arnold Standard Surface in it. I'm going to rename the container to Lampshade MTL. And let's do the same for the lamp stem. Right-click, under Assign New Material, select Arnold AI Standard Surface. And I'm going to rename this one Lamp Stem MTL. Let's work on the material for the lampshade first. Right-click, select Show in LookdevX. And we see the material container in the LookdevX graph editor. Double-click to go inside the container. Here's the AI Standard Surface shader. To achieve this particular look for the lamp, I painted this lotus flower in Procreate and produced these images for the frames. For the paper, I downloaded this texture from tilingtextures.com, and my colleague Dusan Kovic provided this image that I used for the paper wrinkles. Here's a diagram showing the steps involved in creating this material. The base color is created by layering the lotus flower and the paper images. For the properties such as specular, transmission, and subsurface, we use a combination of color correct and range nodes to adjust the parameters. The frame and the surface details are created with the bump2D node, and the bump map is generated from layering the frame and wrinkle images. I'm going to create the base color first. Let's get an image node. There are a few image nodes. The first one is for Arnold. The ones that start with ND are for MaterialX. Let's rename it Paper. In the Parameters panel, load the paper image. Get another image node and rename it Lotus Flower. Load the Lotus Flower painting. To layer them, we use the node Layer RGBA. Connect the lotus flower to layer 1 and the paper to layer 2. Enable both layers and change the operation of the first layer to overwrite. And connect the output to base color. For Arnold materials, we need to render the scene to see them in the viewport. I've already created a point light and sky dome light. Click the Render button. Now we see the paper with the painting. In the Parameters panel, we can adjust the UV coordinates to make it look better. This looks good to me. Next, I'll create the bumps. Again, using the Image node, I'm going to load the image for the vertical bars of the frame. Get another one for the horizontal bars. And another one for the paper wrinkles. Get a layer RGBA node. Before layering the images, I'm going to use the range node to remap the color values of each image into a different range. This allows us to easily adjust the look of the bumps. Connect them to layer 1, 2, and 3 respectively. Get a bump 2D node. And connect the output to geometry normal. In the parameters panel of the layer node, let's enable all the three layers. Change the operation of the second and third layers to plus. And decrease the mix value of the third layer so that the wrinkle image wouldn't override the frames. To know more about layering in Arnold, go to the Arnold Online Help, where you'll find the details of all the operations. Now if I render it, we see some bumps. I'm going to adjust the UV scales and the ranges to make it look right. This looks a lot more convincing. Now I'm going to adjust some of the properties including specular, transmission, and subsurface. I'm going to speed up a little here. You can take a look at the scene file if you want to see all the values that I used. For specular, I'm using the color correct node to inverse the color values of the base color, so that the lotus flower will be more reflective than the background, and I'm using a range node to adjust the intensity and the contrast. Similarly, I'm connecting color correct to another range node for the specular roughness. For the transmission, because I want the background to be more transparent than the painting, I'm connecting the base color directly to a range node without using the color correct. And for the subsurface, again, combination of color correct and range nodes for the subsurface weights. And the colors from the paper image as the subsurface color. Let's render it again. And now we get a more realistic looking paper lamp. To make the graph look more organized, we can group nodes into compounds. For example, we can select these nodes, right-click, and select Create Compound. I'm going to name this compound Lotus Parameters. I'll also rename the layer node. Similarly, we can select the nodes for the bumps. Create a compound and name it Lotus Bump. Now the graph looks cleaner. That's the material for the lampshade. To edit the material for the stem, we follow a similar procedure. Let's go back to the top level of the graph. Select the material container for the stem. Right-click under Show in LookdevX. Select the same graph where we edited the material for the lampshade. Go inside the container. And for the stem, I'm just going to change the base color of the surface. You can experiment with the nodes we just learned, such as image, range, and bump 2D to add more details. I'm going to rename this surface shader Standard Surface Stem and go back to the lampshade material and rename this shader Standard Surface Shade. And don't forget to save the stage. There are other parameters that we can adjust. For example, if we want to make the surface double-sided, we can select the prim, go to the Attribute Editor, under Geometric Prim, check Double-Sided. You can also adjust the parameters of the lights to further improve the look. That's it for today. Please stay tuned for the next video where we'll create instances of the lamp and learn how to quickly create variations in the look of the lamps. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.